We're not used to seeing the Wago name up in lights. We normally associate Wago with high quality screwless connectors, but today we're going to look at a new product for us. It's these MID energy meters from Wago. Energy, bit of a hot topic, Gary.
Hot topic. Energy prices have gone through the roof, and you know the old saying, if you can measure it, you can manage it. So we installed one behind us in our Luden top tier board, but why did we do that for?
Yeah, well, it came along just in time, actually, because we're going to explore one of the dirty secrets of EV charging. And to do that, we're going to need to know how much energy does it actually take to charge an EV. So watch out for that video coming along. There may be a few surprises in there for EV owners and infrastructure providers. But I guess let's have a look at the meter itself.
Here we go.
So as you'd expect from Wago, incredibly easy to install because we've got screwless connectors throughout. So this meter does not need external current clamps, so you can power up to 65 amps through this meter. And as you'd expect, because of that, there's some quite chunky terminals along the bottom here. But here's a conventional solid meter tail. So this is 25 millimeter squared.
And that's the largest size it can accept?
Yep, so that just pushes into the cage clamp, and then we've got a great connection there. I can repeat the process with a flexible tri-rated cable here, but I've put a uninsulated ferrule on there. So this is 16 millimeter squared. And again, you can just push that into the cage clamp. The only time I need to lift the levers was if I was using a flexible conductor. So again, lift the lever, pop it in there, and then it's down.
I noticed that they're all in a line there. So we've got L1, L1, L2, L2, and L3, L3 for our connections, which is pretty common to a meter, isn't it?
Yeah, so there's two versions. So this one where all the connections for the main power are at the bottom. The one we've installed in the panel behind us has the power flowing through the meter. So a set of connections at the bottom and a set at the top.
Okay.
To remove the conductors, obviously you still do have to lift the levers up. And again, that's a simple process, but I think the speed of connection. And then you'll notice it's a nice clear design there.
It is,
yep. Great. Obviously it shows off the electronics inside, but you can also see the strip length for the conductors on the terminal block as well by looking at the side of the meter. So 19 millimeters in this case.
When I think of metering, I think of the potential maybe that if this was used in a process, I could bypass me, easy lift these levers and join them together and actually not be measuring any of the energy.
Oh, that's dishonest of you, Gary. So these are MID meters, which is the Measuring Instrument Directive. So there's a set of standards that meters have to comply with, particularly if you're going to use them for billing. And as part of that, they do have to have a cover. So this cover obviously stops you getting to the terminals. And through here, you can put a lead seal so you can tell if it's been tampering. Interesting as well, in the metering, in the data you can get out of the meter, you can also tell how many times it's been powered down as well.
Oh, right, okay.
So if you kept an eye on that, you might be able to spot some nefarious tampering going on in there.
So we've got that information, we're reading our energy, okay, and we now want to obviously manage that energy, so we need to send it somewhere. Can we send that information to a BMS system?
Yes, you can. So you'll notice there's more terminals on the top of this meter, again, all screwless terminals, so this way you'd connect to a BMS system using Modbus or MBus to a higher level energy management system. So perhaps you're collecting the data from lots of different machines or panel boards to obviously build up a profile for a whole building to see what's going on.
We didn't use that here. We used Bluetooth, didn't we? There was a QR code in order that we could read on our device the information that's stored within that meter. Can you talk me through this Bluetooth connection?
Okay, really simple. There's some touch sensitive buttons at the bottom of the meter. So hold the middle one down for 3 seconds. Touch again brings up a QR code. So now I can open up the Wago Energy Meter app. I could also connect with a regular Bluetooth scan at this point, but I'm going to take a photograph of that QR code via the app. So that's dead simple. There we go. Recognize the QR code. So now I can look at the values in the meter. So let's look at the recorded energy. So you can see there what we've been using in kilowatt hour. Oh, there's negative flow there for some reason. We'll come back to that, I'm sure. But then you can see energy per phase. You can look at reactive energy and you can capture all of that. So this is obviously historic. This is what the meter's been reading. So there is a lot of information, certainly more than you can display on that display. There is a lot of information on the display, but again, this app gives you granular detail about what's going on the meter. I could then export it, so save and export that as a CSV file. And I can see I could WhatsApp that to you, Gary, and you could analyse that in detail.
I'd let you keep that information if that's okay.
Yeah, so I'm just going to save that, and then let's have a look at the instantaneous energy values. So we can go in there. So now we can see our line voltage, so line to neutral voltage, the current per phase, power per phase, reactive power per phase. So this is useful if you're going to do some power quality analysis. Check your phases are balanced, and obviously this can give you some telltale signs possibly if something's wrong, obviously if you're tracking this over a period of time. So again, we can scan through that. There's a lot of information, even your phase to phase voltages there as well, and the all important power factor. Again, we can save and export this if we wanted to as well. So again, just I could save that file to desktop if we just wanted to analyze that a little bit later. Can also access the settings within the meter itself. So say we wanted to set up that Modbus connection, we can go in there and alter the specific parameters for that. So the communication rate. And there's where you can see that power down counter as well. So you can see how many times the meter's been powered down. So you might be looking for tampering or evidence of power cuts since you've last did a meter read. So again, useful functions in there. Go back out there. Oh, there you go. You can see the part number, and you know I love a part number, and you can also see the serial number, which is mirrored in the display on the meter as well. So you can obviously check that you're reading the meter that you expect to be reading.
When I was looking at those readings, it looked remarkably like we were exporting power. Have we got the ability to go from car to grid, Gordon?
Not quite yet, Gary. It was just the excitement over the weekend of doing the first install of this meter. I actually put it round the wrong way, and hence you'll see a negative power flow. However, I do think that then demonstrates the fact that this meter can measure both positive and negative power flow. So if you've got micro generation built into the installation, you can capture that and record it. You can also have multiple tariff inputs to it. So there's two tariff inputs on the top. So say you had an off-peak energy profile that you wanted to measure separately, you can do that. And you can access another two using the BMS if you're set up to do that as well. So some, again, more powerful features.
I think you styled out of that one nicely. It easily fits on that DIN rail, and we can see the levers, obviously, because you made the error, I would suggest, obviously, the levers mean you just have to pop them out and return the terminals into the correct order,
don't
you?
It was quick to correct the error. And again, that's the benefit of these screwless connectors. People are obviously thinking, well, this is 65 amps we can handle directly through this meter. What if you want to go higher than that? You can also get a version of this meter that will work with external 1 or 5 amp current transformers if you've got a bigger distribution board to measure. And that's where probably a lot of viewers may have seen this. Right. We have covered energy management on the channel before, and some people just didn't get the whole concept. But actually getting to grips with energy can make a massive cost difference to any business. In a commercial electricians are probably used to seeing this in subboards, particularly where flow meters are above 500 meters squared and 1,000 meters squared as part of part L. If this is a whole new concept for you, we have got a CPD on that topic that looks at energy management with regards to lighting in more detail.
Okay, that's fantastic. But I've also seen them recently when I popped down to Park Erin, where we looked at the House of the Future, that actually had metering. I think it was 4 or 5 meters in there, metering everything at a granular level. What's the thinking behind that?
That was the first time we'd seen three phase in a domestic installation, and they had put an enormous amount of metering in there, all interconnected, so they could remotely understand at a granular level where the energy flow is going in that property. Now, whether that rolls out on mass scales and we'll see lots more metering at a domestic level remains to be seen, but they'd used a full functionalities of meters, including that remote communication, to get to grips with it.
And that comes back to it, doesn't it? If you can measure it, you can manage it. And they were measuring it every single point so they could reduce the energy. And we know how important it is. We're going to a fully electric world, we believe. So therefore, knowing how much electricity you're using is vitally important in order to keep the cost down, isn't it? Mm-hmm.
So let us know what you think. Have you installed this meter? How do you think it compares to other ones on the market? Is energy monitoring a whole new field that you'd like to get into? Obviously, put those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.